video, we will be learning about the varicose veins. This will be the part 1 of the video. And we will be discussing about the basic anatomy of veins in legs, the definition of varicose veins, the risk factors, the most probable sites where varicose veins occur, the types, the clinical classifications, and the clinical features. So, let us learn the basic anatomy of veins in the lower limbs. The venous return from the lower limbs usually comes from the deep and the superficial veins. The deep veins lie deep to the deep fascia, and the superficial veins lie superficial to the deep fascia. The deep veins include the anterior tibial vein, the posterior tibial vein, peroneal vein in calf, popliteal vein near knee, and the femoral vein in thigh. The superficial veins are the short saphenous vein and the long saphenous vein. The deep veins are more prone to the DVT or the deep vein thrombosis. We have discussed about the deep vein thrombosis in our previous videos. The link will be given in the description box below, so make sure you check it out. And the superficial veins, which are the short and the long saphenous veins, are more prone to the varicose veins, which we will discuss in detail in this video. So the normal blood flow occurs from the superficial veins to the deep veins. Valves are present to prevent the backflow of blood. Incompetent valves will cause backflow of blood and may lead to the formation of varicose veins. So let us now discuss in detail about the superficial veins. The short saphenous vein ends at the saphenopopliteal junction and drains into the deep vein system. It is accompanied by the sural nerve. The long saphenous vein ends at the saphenofemoral junction, which is 4 cm below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. It is accompanied by the saphenous nerve. There are perforators which form bridge between the deep and the superficial veins. These perforators are 5 in number. The first 3 being the Cockett perforators, which are present in the lower leg 5, 10 and 15 cm apart from the medial malleolus. The Boyd perforator is present below the knee and the Dodd perforator is present in the thigh. So this is the basic anatomy of the venous system in the lower limbs. Now let us see the definition of the varicose vein. A varicose vein is an elongated, dilated, tortuous and thickened vein due to continuous dilation under pressure. The risk factors that lead to the formation of varicose veins may be familial inheritance or heredity, female gender, advancing age, prolonged standing or obesity. The major sites where varicose veins can be seen are the long and the short saphenous veins, or it may be present as a varicocele, hemorrhoids or esophageal varices. Coming to the clinical classification of varicose veins, there are 6 grades. In grade 0, there are no visible or palpable signs of venous disease. In grade 1, there is telangiectasia or reticular veins or the malleolar flare. Grade 2 is presented with the varicose veins. In grade 3, there is cutaneous edema without any skin changes. Here, the skin changes refer to the eczema, pigmentation or the lipodermatosclerosis, which we will be dealing in the complications of varicose veins. Grade 4 is presented with the skin changes, and in grade 5 there are skin changes with healed ulcer, and in grade 6 skin changes are present with an active ulcer. Based on their etiology, varicose veins are divided into the primary varicose veins, where there is no underlying cause and it might be due to intrinsic valvular and saphenofemoral incompetence. The secondary varicose veins occurs due to some underlying pathology. This may be due to obstruction to venous outflow, which may be caused because of pregnancy, pelvic tumors, iliofemoral thrombosis, or inguinal lymphadenopathy. Other pathologies include valve destruction due to DVT, congenital or traumatic arteriovenous fistula. Coming to the clinical features, varicose veins is usually asymptomatic. On progression of disease, patient may present with skin complications like ulceration, eczema, pigmentation, and swollen ankle. Dull ache in calf muscles and lower leg occurs due to pooling of blood in superficial veins. Patient complains of worsening of symptoms by evening. So, that's the basic introduction to the varicose veins. In our next video, we'll be discussing the clinical examination, the clinical tests, investigations, treatment and complications of varicose veins, including the white cell hypothesis and the fibrin cuff theory. Thank you for watching. Do like the video if you found it informative, share it with your friends and subscribe to the Dentist Hub for more updates.